So my freshman year, I took a class from Dr. Gross, who's a professor here at BYU. And she's been a big advocate for Be the Match. And she took some time during one of her lectures to just explain what Be the Match was and what their mission was. And at the time, I thought, wow, that's something really cool. But I actually didn't swab then, and just stayed in the back of my mind for like months. And then one day, I was sitting down in my apartment. I didn't really have anything else to do. And it just popped up in my mind, like, hey, you should go online and do that. So I mailed swab kit to myself and swabbed, and that's kind of how it all started.
I was first diagnosed with essential thrombocythemia in 2008. It was rough. But anyhow, come a long way, had a lot of good people.
I was just driving home in my car. I got like a random call from a phone number I didn't recognize, and I answered it, and it was Be the Match. I could not believe, because I'd only been on the registry for a couple months, and I have an aunt who's been on it her whole life, never gotten a call. So it was very unexpected. They said that there was a 67-year-old woman who I was a potential match for, who was in need, and asked if I would be able to commit at that time and be a donor. And I was a little nervous, but I was also super excited, just knowing that there was someone out there who needed my help. So I said yes, and we're here now.
October 5th, got my stem cells. That's my new birthday. My doctor, he told me that initially it would take 2 to 3 bags of stem cells. And the stem cells that I received were so strong, I only had to have one bag.
I was a little nervous leading up to donation just because it's something new. I didn't really know what to expect. But it really was just knowing that there was someone out there, like there was a real person who needed my help and no one else could help her. That just helped me overcome some of those nerves, that anxiety that I had.
When they first told me about the donor, I wondered why would a young man want to do something like this? And I told my coordinator when I first went in that I want to be able somewhere down the road to meet my donor and or at least talk to him. When I got the call, oh my gosh.
I'm a little nervous, I'm not gonna lie, but I'm excited too. She's an older woman. I've kind of thought of her almost as like my grandma. And I had a grandma that passed away from cancer a couple years ago, and that was a big motivator for me to join the registry. Just thinking of the opportunity to give someone else more time with their grandma, time that I didn't have. So I'm just excited to meet like my grandma, basically. I'm looking forward to it.
Carson, I am your adopted grandma. You can't get rid of me. We might not get to talk real often, but I'm always here, always.
I think that Be the Match is a really unique opportunity to serve people in a way that you can't any other way. You're literally giving them the opportunity at life, and it's just a couple hours out of your day, really. Maybe a little bit of mild discomfort, but when you put that in the perspective of curing someone of cancer, it's really hard to argue at all. And looking back, I mean, I'd do it again in a second, for sure.
It's amazing. It's amazing. And I am so thankful, so appreciative. If it's something you're thinking about, it is something that you may never know to help a friend or maybe, you know, a family member or a stranger, you know, just, or you might not ever be needed, but you're there.
Thank you.